guys, Pasty Boy here. Today's video is going to be a drive system diagnosis and probably repair on an old mower. And let me show you that mower. All right, now at first glance, you look at this and say, well, it doesn't really look that old. It's in pretty good shape. But believe it or not, this mower is 28 years old. It's my father-in-law's mower. And I'll just go over briefly with you what it is here. It's a 4-horsepower snapper, extra tough, commercial lawnmower. Now, it has a Wisconsin motor, which is out of business now. But this mower was built tough, and the whole unit here is built to last. I think back then landscapers would buy these because they were so durable. My father-in-law's nephew recommended this mower because it was built so well, and so my father-in-law bought it back then. 28 years ago was $600, which is quite a bit of money for just, you know, a self-propelled mower. But seeing that he's got 28 years out of it and it still looks like this and it's going to get some more use too, I think he spent his money wisely. So today's problem is that the drive system is no longer engaging, and we're going to have to take a look at that and see why. All right, so I removed the bagger so that I could get a look at the how the drive system works, and it actually looks like the system like a snowblower works, where it's like a friction disc system. So let me zoom in here and show you what I'm talking about. See those? You got the shaft, and so if you want to change speeds, you pull this lever and it slides over and it changes the position of, you know, it's kind of like a gear ratio. So if you're familiar with how a snowblower speed control works, this is the same type of system. So now what I got to do is start it up, engage the system, and see what it does. So as you can see, I pull the lever and nothing engages. So I'm going to dig a little deeper. All right, so what it looks like to me is that the belt is really worn out and it's definitely off its track here. So let me see if I can get a view of it from here. Kind of hard to see. But you can see there that the belt isn't even on the pulley. So let me look from over here. And you can kind of see there that it's flipped and not on the pulley. So we're going to try to, at least, at the very least, get that belt back on track. You can see here, it's also not on the pulley. It's quite worn. And it's Sunday today when I'm making this video, so I can't go buy the belt today. Alright, so I removed the chute on the right side of the mower so that I could get a lot better access to the belt and pulley area. So I think my first attempt is going to be just to get the belt on correctly, but it definitely needs a new belt. But like I said, I can't get that today. Alright, so I got the belt back on the right way. It'll work for today, I believe, but it definitely needs a new belt. My other concern is that the flat disc on the bottom there is a little wobbly. And it's kind of hard to tell like this, but you can see that this pulley is getting chewed up by the bottom of this disc. So, you know, gotta see why this is so loose. But at the same time, you know, the belt is probably the original 28-year-old belt. So that's definitely gonna get replaced. But I'm gonna see if this is gonna do the trick for today. I'm also gonna take a quick look and see if I could get that more stable. All right, so there was a 9/16 nut on the bottom side of this disc. I just tightened it up a couple of turns and boom, it leveled right out. Pulley's clearing perfectly. So I think that's gonna help a lot. And then this thing should work perfectly when we get the new belt. So what I'm gonna do for now is put the chute back on and just give it a test. See if it drives without breaking the belt. Okay, you could probably tell in that video that the lawn looked mowed already. That was because I actually mowed the entire front lawn there after I got this fixed. Now, I didn't replace the belt, even though it does need to be replaced, but I got it working. Put the belt back on properly, and then it still wasn't working, so I noticed this friction disc system here wasn't making very good connection. It was just, you know, kind of skipping along the top and it was really wobbly. So I added a spring there, which probably had one there and it had broken and fallen off. So I added a spring back in and now it's working great, as you saw in the video. So there you have it, another fixed drive system. I'll still replace the belt eventually, but for now, it's working, and I'm going to let my father-in-law know that it's working, but we'll replace the belt soon. So there's the Snapper Hi-Vac commercial, extra tough, 4-horse Wisconsin mower.
Thanks for watching, guys. Take care.